as dreamers do. for being here for our production of Rodgers and Hammerstein's Cinderella. We're so excited to get to do this. Every 2 years, the performing arts departments come together, and it's an amazing collaborative experience. As you can see, we're working with our amazing FCS band under the direction of Mr. Tyndall and Mr. Curry, and our amazing choir director, Janine Stemmer, and the choral department, and of course, the drama department. And also represented tonight, we have our culinary arts department back there selling amazing treats. So it's just so fun when we get to come together and celebrate the arts and the gifts that God has bestowed upon these kids to glorify Him. And that's what we're here to do tonight. So I hope you'll join me in a brief word of prayer before we begin the show. Please bow your heads. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for tonight. We thank you for the love that is in this room that we know comes from you. We know that every good thing comes from you. We thank you for song and for dance and for stories. And I just pray that you would bless this experience, bless our audience and our students this evening. It's in your name we pray. Amen. We hope you enjoy the show.
Hidden man. I just wish I was doing something more important with my life.
Worrying about that self-limiting.
It all just comes too easily.
The fact remains, sire, you will be king and very soon. When your sainted mother and father passed away and left you in my charge, I promised them that when you came of age, you would be prepared for your reign.
I know. And I guess I am ready to be king. The thing is, I don't even know who I am yet.
I'm sure it will come to you. Until then, might I suggest faking it?
Really?
Well, you wouldn't be the first, and you wouldn't be the last.
To the castle.
To the castle. Still, these questions nag me. Nag, nag, nag. No, not you, Buttercup. Still, I wonder. Me, who am I? A far from perfect guy. A bum who wants to do what's right, but often does what's wrong. A kid whose voice is way off key, but loves to sing a song. A guy who dreams like a lion, but wakes up like a lamb. Me, who am I? But the guy I am.
A guy who dreams like a lion, but wakes up like a lamb.
Get him! Get him! Get him! Go! 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 Go!
Me, who am I but the guy I am?
He's our hero.
Oh, stop!
Such perfection.
That's too kind.
He's the kind of guy.
That.
What's the use of self-reflection?
Too good.
Church bells will ring when you are king. People will sing. There is no one quite like
me.
His Royal Highness.
Who am I?
Christopher Rupert.
A far from perfect guy.
It is the ogres.
A jerk who wants to do what's right, but often does what's wrong. A kid. A guy who dreams like a lion, but wakes up like a lamb. Me, who am I, but the guy I am. That whom I, that whom I.
What a guy.
Ha!
Us some water.
Yes, sir.
Hey, don't speak to her that way. How do you know she's poor?
Look at her. She's filthy.
Here you are, sire.
Thank you, young lady. That's very kind of you.
It's just water.
Give her some money.
Really?
Oh, yes, it's charity. You have things and she doesn't. You would give her some of your things so she doesn't have a revolution and take all of your things. The moment charity is mentioned, out comes every layabout.
Here you are, old woman.
Oh, thank you. Bless you, kind sir.
Be careful, my lord. Many of the very poor have weapons.
Take guard with you.
No! Good sirs, this is merely Crazy Marie. She only comes to town to gather what others throw away. She is gentle in every way, sweet and delicate, but nuts.
She's harmless. Sebastian, Lord Pinkleton, sheathe your swords. You're a great friend to Marie.
How lucky she is to have a friend such as you. I wish I had a true friend in this world.
I'm standing right here.
Shall we journey on?
Very well, Pinkleton. Farewell, young lady.
Oh, I don't want any charity.
Take the coin, then, as a gift for a true friend in this world. Farewell. Sorry, a lot on my mind.
Ahem! Thank you for saving my life, dear Ella. I shall return the favor.
Oh, I didn't do it to have a favor returned.
I have a shawl here that only has a few holes and smells of cabbage, but you can wear
it. Not necessary. What a handsome man that was, and so kind and generous.
That is not a man. That is Prince Topher, the slayer of giants and dragons. He has just returned to us from the university. He is to be crowned king.
That man, a world leader? But he appears to have a heart, mind, and soul. It can't be. Marie, you're crazy.
Yes. Yes, I am. But that does not change the fact that he is our very own Prince Topher, and he is to be our ruler. Look at your coin, dear.
Why, it is him. From the left, such silly ears. And that big crown doesn't help things. He should wear a floppy hat. Here, Marie, please take this coin. Buy yourself something warm to eat.
Wine is always the very kindest or the most generous. It breaks my heart.
And here is our Don Michel. He will spout gibberish now and Boris.
Be nice. Good day, Jean-Michel.
And do you know why, Ella and Crazy Marie, that the poorest are the most generous?
No, but I have a feeling you are about to be the most forthcoming.
Because it is a corrupt system with a smashed moral compass.
You will forgive me if I just stagger about and mutter.
Today, I will be going alone to the castle to protest the corruption that riddles our government. You both must come with me.
Cinderella! That is Madame Ella's stepmother.
I will shout to the prince. He will have no choice but to listen.
Cinderella! You are in harm's way!
I have a vision for what this kingdom could be.
Cinderella, help me with my parcels. It's instant. Careful, careful. No one knows the extreme torture I'm subjected to. I'm ignoring that. Daughters, come, come.
We are here, Mama. We are exhausted being as beautiful as we look.
Cinderella! Idle girl! Help your stepsisters with their shrewd purchases! Into the house, daughters! The real ones!
Madame is always this mean. Sometimes she sleeps.
Gabrielle, I've brought with me from university a book with pictures of how people in other lands live and how they govern. Norway, Italy, Japan.
I have mentioned my interest in these places only in passing, and you have brought me a whole book? Could it, you?
And 4 days from now, I would like to take you on a date. I'm organizing a soup kitchen. We need someone to stir. And ladle.
Gabrielle! Do not talk to that man! We are teetering precariously between upper middle class and lower upper class. We cannot be seen with a revolutionary. Into this house at once!
Why do I care? Why do I try? I'll never be good enough for her. I'll take this book and burn it.
Why not give the book to dear Ella?
Well, if it's quite all right, Jean-Michel, I would love to look at your book of how other countries live.
Here, take it, Ella. I shall go on my way alone, live my own life. I'm a loner.
Can I hold him?
You're coming with me, right?
Of course.
Good.
A book. It's been so long since I've owned something. Just me.
Cinderella, get in here and clean the kitchen.
I've just finished it.
Then the bed's mossed.
Beds are all turned down and your bed clothing is all laid out.
Well, where'd you get that book?
Jean-Michel.
How lovely! People just give you gifts! Still daddy's little girl. And what's that?
That's my father's coat.
It's rags.
It's all I have to remember him by.
It's rags now. Clean the porch with these rags.
I'm as mild and as meek as a mouse. When I hear a command, I obey. But I know of a spot in my house where no one can stand in my way. In my own little corner, in my own little chair, I can be whatever I want to be. Can fly anywhere, and the world will open its arms to me. I'm a young Norwegian princess or a milkmaid. I'm the greatest prima donna in Milan. I'm an heiress who has always had herself made by her own flock of silkworms in Japan. I'm a girl men go mad for, love's a game I can play with a cool and confident kind of air. Just as long as I stay in my own little corner, all alone in my own little chair. I can be whatever I want to be. Queen in Peru, I'm a mermaid dancing upon the sea. I'm a huntress on an African safari. It's a dangerous type of sport, and yet it's fun. In the night, I sally forth to seek my quarry. My gun. I am lost in the jungle all alone and unarmed when I meet a lioness in her lair. Then I'm glad to be back in my own little corner.
Just as long as I stay in my own little corner. A list of the lords entreating me with what?
105 requests.
That seems a lot.
I'll take this. Your Majestic Highness, in honor of your upcoming coronation, we proudly proclaim your kingdom a land of plenty and bounty. May I have the imprimatur of your ring on this other announcement?
Right. Sorry, what's it for again?
It's complicated. Do you really want me to get into it?
Prince Topher, listen!
What's that?
You need to take responsibility for your actions.
Who's that screaming on the other side of the moat?
The people are being treated unfairly by your government.
He seems upset.
Rabble rouser, ignore him. I have this new law which forbids any. But actually, if it would hand me the ring, it would save the trip.
We should invite him up to talk. People were never this upset with Mom and Dad, were they?
Your mother and father had the good fortune of being royalty in a time of plenty. But since your unfortunate demise, I have done my best to run this country. I have done my best to raise you in the finest schools.
Hello? I'm talking here.
Ignore him.
I won't give up. If you won't listen, I'll shout this to the town square.
Shout this to the town square? Perhaps it's time for a distraction.
Ooh, what kind of distraction?
A royal wedding.
Wow. And does that work?
Like a dream every time.
But who'll get married?
Well, you.
Me? But I don't know any girls. I went to an all-boys school off in the woods and an all-male university on an island. Why'd you do that to me?
For this happy day, I am going to find you a bride. Oh, happy the day.
Find me a bride? That's nonsense. How'll you find me a bride?
We shall have a magnificent ball. Dancing.
What?
Every eligible young woman who can afford a gown will attend the ball. That is a wonderful selection process right there. If you cannot afford a nice dress, you have no business marrying a prince. Now, you will dance with every girl. Everyone will be wearing masks. At the stroke of midnight, everyone will remove their masks, and you will have found your bride.
That's fast.
King and queen on the throne, I'm there to guide you through all of your decisions. It's really a win-win.
But who will fall in love with me so quickly?
A valid question, which we will answer sometime soon. Now, Lord Pinkleton, I want you to tell this to all. A pronouncement! An announcement! His Royal Highness Christopher
please,
Rupert.
Please don't say my whole name.
Windermere, Vladimir, Carl Alexander.
It's embarrassing.
Francois Reginald, Lancelot Herman.
Hartman?
Herman.
Gregory James is giving up all.
Sebastian, dancing? Can we please talk about this?
Now is the time to act. No other time will do. Live and play your part. Don't give away your heart. Don't take what the world gives you. No, 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 listen, tradespeople, tinkers, fishmongers. I shout to the prince, but he ignores me. If he and Sebastian think that they can take the land from the very poor, then it's only a matter of time before they take from all of us. For you just can't wait to be served by fate on a silver plate or a tray.
Now is the time of your life, the time of your life is today.
The prince is giving up all, the prince is giving up all. And that's not all, the prince is giving up all, the prince is giving up all. Christopher Rupert James is giving up all. The prince is giving up all. The prince is giving.
Now is the time to act. Now is the time to live.
The prince is giving up all.
Hey!
He's giving up all. The prince is giving up all.
His Royal Highness Christopher Rupert, Windermere, Vladimir, Carl Alexander, Francois Reginald, Lancelot, Herman.
Herman?
Amen. Gregory James is giving a ball.
The prince is giving a what?
The prince is giving a ball. The prince is giving a ball.
His Majesty has this decree. To attend the ball, all one requires is an invitation and suitably fashionable attire. And the prince will choose someone from the ball to be his bride. That means anyone can be the queen!
So will he want a taller girl?
Or will he want a stronger girl?
Or will he want a smaller girl?
The prince is giving a ball.
I wish I were a bolder.
I wish I were a younger girl.
Cock and twaddle. The prince is giving a ball.
Delicate Charlotte's corset.
Oh, I can taste my lunch.
Then we must move on to Gabrielle's hair. It's beginning to look, I fear, like a Bavarian pretzel. Cinderella! 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 Cinderella, it is the most amusing name. I crack myself up. Her name is Ella, and she sits by the cinders of the fire. So I call her Cinder Ella. Why don't I have any friends?
Face it, Mama. You are well-versed in the art of ridicule.
I do have a flair for it, don't I, actual daughters? Watch and learn.
Cinderella, hurry. Get dressed quick. You're going to the ball. You're going to find a husband.
I am?
Ridicule. Who caught it?
I did.
That's terrible.
Who could that be at this hour? Everyone clear out of here while I get rid of this imbecile. What brand of idiot what? Sebastian, what an unexpected delight.
Madam, I have but a moment. I invite you to hang upon my every word.
Invitation accepted.
Tonight's ball shall be in masks. The prince will be wearing a white mask. What color mask will your daughter Gabrielle be wearing?
Why pink?
If the daughter is anything like the mother, I think the pink mask and the white mask shall meet and fall in love.
Are you implying what I'm inferring?
Your daughter is all part of my master plan.
You are brilliant!
You are perceptive. I shall see you at the ball. Together, we shall make this so.
Daughters, come quick! Oh, Gabrielle, look at you! You too, Charlotte. But really, look at Gabrielle! Cinderella, bring me the orange box. Necklaces made out of Venetian glass, more valuable than diamonds. Each one of you shall wear the tiniest bauble around your neck. For my daughter, help me there, Cinderella, please. For my daughter, Gabrielle. And for my courageous Charlotte. Who could that be at this hour? It must be good news.
Good evening, madame. Gabrielle, I hope you don't mind my interrupting your momentous evening. I just thought you might want these for the ball tonight. Wildflowers, I picked them myself.
Thank you, Jean-Michel. They're so beautiful.
For the mother of the most perfect girl in all God's creation, I've picked them myself and...
Leave! And take your simple pleasures with you!
Would you perhaps consider if I...
No!
Madame, don't be so mean. That was so nice!
No, 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 no! Mr. Soapbox!
But he means well, and I think he likes me.
Let me tell you something about love. Miss flowers in your hands and dreams in your head. I married your father for love. He died, and I cried. Then I married Cinderella's father for money. He died, and I got a house. 7:30, ball preparations, double time. Cinderella, my shoes. Necklace, hair. Cinderella, is it going anywhere?
One of the flowers in the bouquet was a wild rose. Its thorn scratched my lip. I'm bleeding. I should walk up to the prince, scratch his lip.
Oh, now.
Wow.
Make him drink lemonade. Make it sting.
That's just cruel.
Enough of taking things as they are. Now's the time for us, the tradespeople, the peasants, to march to the palace steps and convince the prince to listen to us instead of having his fancy ball.
You should do that. You should go to the prince and talk to him.
He won't listen to me. He uses his castle to hide from the truth. Him meeting me will never happen. The only thing funnier would be if you went to the ball. You know what? Yeah, why don't you go to the ball and ask the prince when he's going to start noticing? Noticing that his people are being evicted from their land. It's absurd.
Jean-Michel! I could go to the prince, and he might even listen to me. And, well, maybe if I had a ball gown, I think I might look sort of nice. I am in the royal palace of all places. When you meet the finest prince you'll ever see. And the color on my two stepsisters' faces is a queer sort of sour apple green. I am coy and flirtatious when alone with the prince.
Crazy
Marie, are you mocking me with your gibberish?
Yes. Falderoy and fiddle-dee-dee, fiddle-dee-faddle-dee-foodle. All the dreamers in the world are dizzy in the noodle.
So what if I have a dream to see the prince again? And to tell him what life in his kingdom is really like and what it can be?
Exactly! Then you'd have to have him fall in love with you.
No one will fall in love with me. Why do you come to visit me tonight?
I just knew I would find you in the same little chair, in the pale pink mist of a foolish dream.
I am being foolish.
Then be foolish with me.
Tell me, what is it you dream of?
Why, an invitation to the ball, I guess.
Right here. There's an invitation.
What? Well, but it's torn.
Don't wait for everything to be perfect. Just go. Now tell me what else it is you dream of.
Oh, well, a white gown. A beautiful white gown sewed with pearls and jewels. And a tiara of diamonds.
And on your feet.
Why, the most beautiful pair of grosgrain pumps I'd imagine.
No, better. The Venetian glass that your stepmother so loves in her trinkets and baubles. An entire pair of shoes made only of Venetian glass.
How silly. I'd be the envy of all. Well, but how would I get to the ball?
Well, this pumpkin right here.
Yes?
I'll turn it into a golden carriage.
Oh, and horses?
Those mice trapped in that cage.
Oh, and a fox as a footman, and a raccoon as a driver. You're crazy, Marie. Why, in order to do that, you would have to be a fairy godmother. Marie! Oh, but you're a crazy woman. What are you doing in that beautiful gown?
You'd be surprised at how many beautiful gowns have crazy women in them.
Are you really my fairy godmother?
Yes, my child. Actually, I'm everyone's fairy godmother. But you're the only one who's ever given me kindness, generosity, and charity. And now I must make all the dreams that we joked about come true.
Well, that's so improbable. Implausible.
Impossible. For a plain yellow pumpkin to become a golden carrot, impossible. For
join in marriage. And four white mice will never be four white horses. Such folderoy and fidelity, of course, is impossible. But the world is full of zanies and fools who won't believe in sensible rules and won't believe what sensible people. Things are happening every day.
Impossible.
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 Impossible. Impossible.
Well, but if you could be a fairy, a beggar woman, not 5 minutes ago, and now you are my fairy godmother, then anything is possible, right?
I suppose so.
Well, then you can change it all. You can make it all happen.
No, you can change it all. You can make it all happen.
Oh, never. I couldn't.
You're right. It's just all so, oh my goodness. What? It's all so impossible for a plain yellow pumpkin to become a golden carrot. Impossible for this plain country bumpkin and a prince to join in marriage. And four white mice will never be four white horses. Such folderoy and fidelity, of course, is impossible.
But the world is full of zanies and fools who won't believe in sensible rules and won't believe what sensible people say.
And because these daft and dewy-eyed dopes keep building up impossible hopes, impossible things are happening every day.
Oh my goodness, so heavy.
I tell you. Okay. Mr. Raccoon, your turn. Let's go. There we go. Wonderful. Ridiculous. My love. Have our little mice, which are now horses. But now, Cinderella, as promised in our laughter, glass slippers. Now, Cinderella, I must tell you, this magic is all very powerful, but it will end at midnight. Now go. Go to the ball. In the name of any girl that wished to go to the ball in a beautiful gown. Go. In the name of every girl who wished to change the world she lived in. Go. With the promise of possibility.
It's possible, it's possible, it's possible, it's
It's possible for a plain yellow pumpkin to become a golden carriage. It's possible for a plain pumpkin and a prince to join in marriage. And four white mice are easily turned to horses. Such folderol and fiddle-dee-dee, of course, is quite possible. For the world is full of zanies and fools who won't believe in sensible rules and won't believe what sensible people say.
And because these daft and two-way idols keep building up impossible hopes, impossible things are happening.
Sebastian, honestly.
Only 200 women to go.
So, which one is he here?
Which one is which?
The prince, duh. Which one is the prince? What do you think I'm here for? The free food?
Well, a good time, a dance perhaps?
Wrong answer. I got marrying royalty in my mind. So, which one is he?
Well, maybe it's me.
Not likely. You're too ordinary.
What makes you think I'm ordinary?
We're doing a gavotte and you can't even keep the beat. When we get to the waltz, you're gonna trip over your two left feet and land in your flat little bottom. End of discussion.
Well, hope to talk to you later then.
I've moved on.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Lovely dance, isn't it? I hope my dancing's all right.
Oh, your dancing's awfully princely. Oops, I let that slip out.
So you know.
I would recognize a wise and handsome prince anywhere.
Well, that last girl didn't know.
You're kidding! Well, thanks for the heads up.
I think she knows now.
Well...
So...
Tell me something about yourself.
What would you like to know, Your Highness?
What are some of your interests?
Oh, any of your interests, Your Highness.
Okay, creepy.
Your Most Majestic Highness, just because I was playing hard to get doesn't mean I'm hard to get.
Okay, very creepy. I'm sorry, Sebastian. I don't think I can do this anymore.
It's a prince!
ridicule! Everyone take sides!
What happened to the nice girl?
Ignore her, we're playing ridicule. You'll be the judge. Two circles spin, and when the music stops, two players will out-ridicule one another. Let's find you a bride. Stop! You and you.
My dear, I love your dress. No matter how many times I've seen it. Why, I remember when it was first in fashion. When I was a young girl.
Please do not talk about your childhood, as I have not brought along a copy of the Old Testament to follow along.
What do you even call that?
Well, it's awfully sophisticated.
Seems more like cruelty to me.
Sophisticated, cruelty. There's a slight difference there. I keep forgetting what it is.
I don't think I want to play anymore.
And here we have another round at the ready. Stop! You and you.
Age before beauty. You first, dear.
I love your speaking voice. Have you ever considered reciting poetry?
Say it. What? Do it. What? The anticipation is killing me. Do the ridicule. Why do you do this to me?
No reason. I just really like your speaking voice, and I think it would sound just wonderful reciting poetry. And I love the feather in your hair. It's a lovely color for you.
Why do you do this to me?
What is this bewitchery you practice?
Well, it's just kindness.
Kindness?
Oh, yes. Kindness is practiced everywhere now. Ridicule isn't used anywhere anymore. It's all kindness now, even in the French courts.
Kindness?
Yes. You know, compassion.
Who are you, you strange woman?
I don't know who she is, but she is very wealthy indeed. And did you see her feet? Shoes made out of Venetian glass. My resentment is all-consuming.
Yes, kindness. You all must try it.
Kindness? I'll be the first. How lovely it is to have a woman such as yourself in our courts.
Thank you. And it's an honor to be at this wonderful party you're throwing.
Ugh, it's like every time they speak, a part of me dies.
You know, I must say, this courtroom is filled with some of the loveliest women I have ever seen.
And I just saw that they had this vanilla cake in the buffet, and it is the best vanilla cake I've ever had. Thank you to whoever made it. Do you want to try this
courtroom?
During the time of Prince Topher's parents.
May his reign be a continuation of theirs.
But so are these.
Look at all these magnificent guests.
Thank you. You are so kind. You make me want to be a better person. But there's something somewhat familiar about you. I wonder what that could be.
I admire how you've changed everything around. And yet I feel so comfortable with you. I feel like we've met before.
Ten minutes ago, I saw you. I looked up when you came through the door. I wanted to ring out the bells and fling out my arms and to sing out the news. 10 minutes ago I met you, and we murmured our how do you do's. I wanted to ring out the bells and fling out my arms and to sing out the news. I have found her, she's an angel. dust of the stars in her eyes. We are dancing, we are flying, and she's taking me back to the skies. In the arms of my love, I'm flying over mountain and meadow and glen. And I like it so well, therefore all I can tell, I may never come down again. I may never come down to earth again.
I'm sorry to be so effusive. I'm not usually like this with someone I've just met. Events like this, I just feel like, what am I doing?
I feel the same.
Like such a phony.
So do I.
You do?
Yes.
Me too. My name's
Topher, short for Christopher. Yes, I know.
Have we met before?
Yes, and we're seeing each other for the very first time right now. And we murmured our how do you do's. I wanted to ring out the bells and fling out my over mountain and meadow and glen. And I like it so well that for all I can tell, I may never come down again. I may never come down to earth again.
We'll be right back.
Just found you.
I don't want to go, but I must.
Don't go.
Prince Topher, there's something I must tell you. You must open your eyes to what's going on in your kingdom. The poor are having their land taken away. You must help them. You must.
I don't think that's kind. How can you say that's kindness?
This is all so wonderful. You are so wonderful, but I have to go.
No, wait, young lady, where are you going? Wait, please stop.
Your Highness, Your Highness.
Charlotte, Gabrielle.
Ladies and gentlemen, we will now have a 10-minute intermission. Enjoy concessions at the back of the gym. Thank you.
Thank you.
She's run off. The girl. She's gone off in a golden carriage. We must find her.
Madame, we will take your carriage.
We have it, the room.
Leave one of your daughters behind, then.
We must find this girl. She is my destiny.
Wait. Seriously, did that just happen? Seriously? Why would a fellow want a girl like her? A frail and fluffy beauty. Why can't a fellow ever once pray for a solid girl like me? She's a frothy little bubble with a flimsy kind of charm. And with very little trouble, I could break her little arm.
Ow! Ow!
Why would a fellow want a girl like her? So obviously unusual. Why can't a fellow ever once pray for a usual girl like me?
Her face is exquisite, I suppose.
But no more exquisite than a rose is.
Her skin may be delicate and soft.
But not any softer than a doe's is.
She's only as dainty as a daisy.
She's only as graceful as a bird. So why is the fellow going crazy? Why would a fellow want a girl like her? A girl who's merely lovely. Why can't a fellow ever once prefer a girl who's merely me? What's the matter with the man? What's the matter with the man? What's the matter with the man?
From the sky!
She's run off! They've got a shortcut through the woods! Boys, lanterns, we must find this girl! We must!
Yes, he's witty, so disarming, and I really like the way he holds a room. Clever, cunning, ever charming, how do I make him see I'm special? It's a pity.
It's a pity.
I'm as pretty.
I'm as pretty.
Plus, I've got the patience of a perfect saint. So I'm waiting, always waiting. Nevertheless, I'm in a mess. Loosen my dress. Help me, I'm starting to faint.
Why would a fellow want a girl like her? A girl who's merely dizzy. Why can't a fellow ever once prefer
a high-strung girl like me? Her face is exquisite, I suppose.
What's the matter with
the man? But no more exquisite than a rose is. Her skin may be delicate and soft. But not
man?
Any softer than a doe's is. Her neck is no wider than a swan's. She's only
man?
As dainty as a daisy. She's only
man?
As graceful as a bird. So why is a fellow going crazy? Oh, oh, why would a fellow want a girl like her? A girl who's merely lovely. Why can a fellow ever once prefer a girl who's merely me?
What's the matter with the man?
What's the matter with the man?
What's the matter with the man?
She's the matter, let me at her!
What's the matter with the man?
What's the matter with the man?
What's the matter?
Thank you.
Majesty.
Lord Pinkleton, where is she?
There are reports along the eastern road of a golden carriage.
10 minutes ago, I held her.
Impossible? Then we must do the impossible.
Ten minutes ago, we were dancing in the palace of all places, and her gown was like a cloud of snowy white, and the moonlight shone its beams upon our faces, till she vanished like a phantom in the night. just know I will find you. You're the girl of my dreams, and the thrill is more than my heart can bear.
Look, a carriage!
That's the one to the west!
I was quite convinced that my daughter was going to become queen, and I never would have to come back to this. And well, here I am, back to this.
Oh, was the ball a disappointment, madame?
The prince, despite him being well-born and taken great care of by our Lord Protector, showed the most appalling manners. Appalling! He spent the entire evening dancing and talking with some little nobody.
Oh, and how did Gabrielle and Charlotte take that?
The prince has fallen head over heels for somebody else. If he keeps this up, I might not want to go out with him.
What was going on through His Royal Highness's thick skull?
The way he looked at her, with respect. Ugh. I hope no man ever looks at me that way.
If that woman had any sense of morality or what's right in this world, she wouldn't have gone to the ball at all.
But can you imagine how she must have felt arriving at the ball dancing with the man of her dreams?
I cannot. For my mind has no place for the puerile or rank.
I can imagine it, I think.
I can imagine it.
I can imagine it. And I have no imagination.
When you're driving through the moonlight on the highway, when you're driving through the moonlight to the dance, you are breathless with the wild anticipation of adventure and excitement and romance. Then at last you see the towers of the palace silhouetted on the sky above the park. And below them is a row of lighted windows like a lovely diamond necklace in the dark.
Looks that way,
the way you say.
She talks as if she knows.
I do not know, these things are so. I only just suppose. I suppose that when you come into the ballroom and the room itself is floating in the air, if you're suddenly confronted by His Highness, you are frozen like a statue on the stair. You're afraid he'll hear the way your heart is beating, and you know you mustn't make the first advance. You are seriously thinking of retreating. Then you seem to hear Him asking you to dance. You make a bow, a timid bow, and shyly answer yes.
How would you know that this is so?
I do no more than guess.
You can guess till you're blue in the face, but you can't even picture such a man.
Such a man.
He is tall and straight.
it too.
This squinting isn't my sinus condition. It's me imagining it.
I'm throwing caution to the wind. I'm imagining it as well.
And imagine what that girl must have felt when dancing with the prince. A lovely night, a lovely night, a finer night you know you'll never see. You meet your prince, a charming prince, as charming as a prince will ever be. The stars in a hazy heaven tremble above you while he whispering, darling, I love you. You say goodbye, away you fly, but on your lips you keep a kiss. All your life you'll dream of this lovely, lovely night.
Charlotte, play the piano forte.
Okay, but it's not gonna be very good. A lovely night, a lovely night, a finer
charming prince, as charming as a prince will ever be.
La 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 la,
la la la. The stars in a hazy heaven tremble above you while he is whispering,
darling, I love you.
You say goodbye, away you fly, but on your lips you keep a kiss. All your life you'll dream of this love.
Whatever that is called. The only thing to comfort me after this disastrous evening is how absolutely devastated the prince looked when his dream date ran away.
Oh, it was hilarious. There was tons of yammery in the powder room about it. Why did the girl run away? My personal belief is that up close, she was physically unappealing.
To bed, my lovely daughters. Cinderella, clean up this pigsty of a parlor. And why is there a pumpkin on the table? It makes no design sense.
Is there anything else you'd like to know, Ella?
No, it really sounds like a magnificent ball. Only I wish I could have been there.
And how did you know everything that happened at the ball this evening?
I just supposed it, imagined it, had a vision.
Interesting. Quick, how many fingers?
Two?
Three. Where are your visions now?
You're being silly. You're just teasing me because I said the prince was wearing a white jacket.
You didn't. And he was. Something's going on here.
You're being absurd. More than usual. I have to finish up here.
Let me help you with that. Your hands are so rough and callous from work. Just like the hand of the woman I shook at the ball who danced with the prince.
I don't know what you're talking about.
It was you, wasn't it? It was you. How did you dance in glass shoes?
You won't tell the others, will you, Madame and Charlotte?
No, never.
Are you mad at me because I stole the prince from you?
I must confess a secret. I never loved the prince or even liked him. There's someone else that I want.
Oh, that's wonderful. Who is it?
Madame hates him.
Well, Madame hating him doesn't narrow the field. Who is it?
If I promise to keep your secret of the prince, do you promise to keep my secret of my forbidden love?
I can, and I will.
It's Jean-Michel, the firebrand.
He's a good man. Well, he seems angry for all the right reasons.
He wants to change the world and make it a better place, and you gotta love a guy like that.
Well, you may one day win Jean-Michel, but I will never win Prince Topher. If he saw me for who I truly was, he would never love me.
That's not true. He would love you for who you are.
I don't see how.
Well, I shudder at the thought of what Madame might do if she finds out about Jean-Michel. Are you sure you can keep my secret?
I can. We shall have a secret. That will make us...
co-conspirators.
Friends.
Sisters.
May we both find our loves.
And our lives. The stars in a hazy heaven, trembling above me,
danced when he promised always to love me.
The day went through,
away I flew, but on my lips he left a kiss.
All my life I'll dream of this.
Lovely,
lovely,
lovely
I wake in the loneliness of sunrise, when the deep purple heaven turns blue, and start to pray as I pray each day that I'll hear some word from you. I lie in the loneliness of evening, looking out on a silver flake sea, and ask the moon, oh, how soon will my love come home to me? I have found her.
She's an angel.
Honestly, sire, 3 nights in a row you search and here it is. 4 o'clock in the morning is as if you were testing my good nature. The second that woman in the whites ran off, which we all must admit seems to imply that she has a police record, the second she is gone, you don't want to dance with any of the other girls.
Sebastian, are there people whose lands have been taken away?
If there were, I would tell you.
Do they need our help?
Everyone donated joyfully. Ignore this talk. Where did you hear it?
The girl.
I don't know that she is to be trusted. Please, please come back to the palace. The work is piling up.
No, no, something's not right.
As you say. The ring, sire.
Right. Right, what's it for again?
Nothing, sire. Hardly worth troubling your beautiful mind about.
Let me read it.
I should explain before you...
I'm reading this.
Your Majestic Highness, let's go back to the palace and allow me to draw up some coverage. You don't want to...
I'm reading this now.
But...
I'll let you know if I need anything explained. Thank you.
Oh no. Sebastian!
Sorry, I can explain.
How could you do this in my name?
I'm maintaining this life for you. Without my watchful eye, you should be a pauper. Would you like that?
I want the girl that talked to me. I want to talk to that girl.
A troublemaker.
We're having another banquet and you're inviting her. She'll come to that.
She won't show. This is lunacy.
We're having another ball and you invite everyone in the kingdom.
Don't forget who you are talking to.
And don't forget who you're talking to. We're having another banquet, a ball.
Very well, Saya. She won't show. You don't even know her name. And if you really thought you were worthy of all of her high ideals, she would have stayed, wouldn't she?
A banquet!
The prince is looking dreamy-eyed, he has since giving the ball. And still he wants to find his bride, the one that he lost at the ball. So spread the word throughout the land, the prince is throwing a banquet!
Hear ye! Hear ye!
It is his wish that the woman that he met at the ball will attend. As for the rest of us, well, what can I say? There's gonna be a ham. Talk it back to me!
Hear ye. Hear ye.
And of course, I want to keep an eye on what women are there. I am not giving up control this time. Spread the word!
Hear ye. Hear ye. His Royal Highness Christopher Rupert James is giving a banquet tonight. Invitation only.
A banquet? Tonight? Cinderella, where are you? Cinderella, where can you be?
His Royal Highness Christopher Rupert, don't be and dream, I can't find his lady. Hoping to see her, asking where is she?
Cinderella, where is she?
Gregory James is giving
a banquet tonight. Two major social events in 1 week. This is cruelty beyond measure. Now granted, my physical appearance has never looked lovelier, but my physical perfection comes at a price. Gloves. That's what it was. Cinderella, where are my gloves?
Eloise, quick. Don't tell her you have her gloves quite yet. Yes, I know she'll be abusive later, but trust me, it shall be worth it. I'm going to tell Madame I'm sick.
Oh, would you like some?
No, I'm not actually sick. I'm just pretending. It's just like when Charlotte was in school and used to pretend to be sick to get out of things she didn't like the third and fourth grade. And just as we are leaving for the carriage, I will be sick. Madame and Charlotte will leave, and I will change back to my regular clothes and meet my secret crush on Michelle. And I'm taking him up on his offer to help in the soup kitchen.
Oh, soup kitchen?
I get the ladle. You heard me. And guess what will happen to both this invitation and one of my beautiful dresses? I shall loan them both to you, and you will go in my stead and meet the prince and fall in love and get married and exact revenge on Madame and keep Jean-Michel out of the stocking and tra-la-la-la-la-la. Just the way my mind works.
Cinderella, where is my glove?
Don't worry about Madame. She never notices anything that isn't her.
Your gloves are right here, Madame.
Cinderella, foolish child, why didn't you tell me you had my glove? Charlotte, make haste. And remember, those shoes are delicate and dainty.
Oh, my feet burn with the heat of 1,000 suns.
Off to the carriage, my daughters.
Oh, madame, my stomach. I must have eaten something this morning that disagrees with me.
No. This cannot be happening. This cannot keep me from going to the ball.
Go without me. Let Charlotte take the prince from the homely woman at the ball. Go, let Charlotte become queen.
I think I can work with that.
Well, Cinderella, go fetch the physician and make sure that Gabrielle gets better. Gabrielle, get better. I insist on it. And keep your invitation. Charlotte, to the carriage.
Thank you, Mother.
No, not on the shoes! Charlotte, let's go!
Quick, you knock on the door and I'll go get dressed.
Oh,
It knocked back.
Good evening, Ella.
Why, hello, Jean-Michel.
I'm sick of hiding in the shadows like a fearful person.
Would you rather see Madame?
Hiding is nice.
How are you this evening?
I'm going out with Gabrielle and I'm wound up like a tick. First, we shall go to the green grocer and beg him for what scraps he might have left. Then, we will slave over a hot stove and serve a meal to the very poor. I do hope she's not expecting this much fun every night.
And your ordeals with the prince, how's that been?
He still hides in his castle. He still has his balls.
Good evening, Jean-Michel.
Good evening, Gabrielle. I much prefer you in the simple attire. You no longer look like a carnival attraction.
Oh, you speak such kind words to me all the day long. And, what of the soup kitchen?
Our first responsibility is with the poor. Then we shall march to the palace steps, and I shall speak with the prince. We have but one problem.
What's that?
That he'll actually speak to me.
Oh, well, Ella might be a help. She talked to the prince, you know.
What?
She went to the ball and she talked to him about the kingdom and how to make things better. And tonight, she's going to the banquet.
This world is upside down. But do you know what this means? If Ella talked to the prince, then that means that I can talk to him and he'll be open to my suggestions. What do you call this feeling I have?
Optimism.
Optimism. I have to do this more often.
You can march up to the prince and talk to him.
I can march up to the prince and talk to
you
him.
You can be a leader.
I can be a leader.
You can be my boyfriend.
I can be your boyfriend. Left turn. What are you doing? This seems very counter-revolutionary.
Well, I like the man who wants to change the world, but I also like the man who bought me flowers.
Who brought you flowers? Oh. I did. No, I couldn't.
You said it yourself. Optimism.
Optimism?
Let yourself go.
I can be your boyfriend?
Yes.
Yes. Am I your boyfriend?
Yes.
Yes.
Mama.
So that's how it is. My own daughter. My flesh and blood deceiving me with someone decidedly so unsuitable. I had plans for you, Gabrielle. I had your whole life planned out for you, and this is how you show your gratitude? And you, do you really think that you can go to court? I never loved your father. I only wanted him for his money. You've been a nuisance to me ever since the day he died. You think you can wear a beautiful gown? You think that is acceptable? You should be in rags! Worn out rags, that's all you deserve!
Mother, please stop!
And you are no longer my daughter. Out of this house, leave! I'll figure out what to do with you later. Why did you have to make me doubt myself? I was doing so well.
A friendly face.
Ella, you must hurry. You shall be late for the banquet.
No! Look! Everything is ruined.
You must go. The prince wants you. He needs you.
No, I can't.
Why do you think he's having the second event tonight to try to find you?
Every time I take a step forward, Madame pushes me back. The prince would never love me if he saw me for who I truly was. I can't keep fighting.
If you have a dream, then very soon thereafter, you're going to have to fight for it. Why, otherwise, how else would you know that the dream is yours?
But my life!
Exactly. It is your life. Beyond the voice that keeps insisting no, doubting, breaking through the darkness, something that sets your heart aglow. Someone wants you, you know who. Now you're living, there's music in you. Now there.
$5 is all I have.
Yes. Well, perhaps we need even more tatters. More rags, rags, rags.
Oh, but...
Rags, rags, rags. Tatters and matters that matter make the new from old. Tatters and rags that shatter spin them into gold. Now, Cinderella, I must tell you, this magic is all very powerful, but it will end at midnight.
Yes, the magic ends at midnight. Was there anything else?
Well, you already have the glass slippers and... Oh, yes, the book! The book that John Michel gave you, the one about the world. Now you only have the whole world to help you. Now you can go wherever you want to go.
Your Majestic Highness, I believe all the guests have arrived. It is time for the banquet.
I have to wait for her. She has to come.
Very well, sire, but be warned, this party is a pack of gossips. I'd hurry along if I were you.
Prince Topher!
You're here.
I'm sorry I'm late. I'm so glad.
I knew if I had a banquet, you'd come.
I'm sorry I ran away before.
And you're even more beautiful than I remember.
Did you really have this banquet just for me?
I would have 100 banquets to find you.
Wow. And the thing about being me being more beautiful than you remembered, that's real too?
Yes, yes, of course.
Wow. What do you know about that?
I've been thinking about you. And I've been thinking of what you said about the people having their lands taken from them. The court tells me to ignore such talk, but I...
You know, if you're going to be king, you're going to have to pay attention to the things people tell you to ignore.
Yes, yes, I know, and I want to meet all my people, not just the ones Sebastian lets me see. I just don't know how. It's impossible.
Well, that's going to be more possible than you can even imagine. My friend Jean-Michel and my sister Gabrielle are headed here right now with some of your people.
To talk to me? But if things are as bad as you say, then they'll be angry with me.
I think if you can do battle with a giant or dragon, I think you can handle a few people who just want to talk to you.
Okay, you're good.
Just be yourself and, well, they'll see the man that I see. They're coming!
Wait, what's your name?
Just trust me because I'm your one true friend. Friends, come meet Prince Topher. Just don't say my name.
Don't worry, I won't say your name and I won't mention that gold dress.
Are you all right?
Yes, yes. Jean-Michel is a wonderful man with a lot of brilliant ideas.
No. It's nice to meet you.
And my sister, Gabrielle. This is Yvonne and her baby.
I see the resemblance.
And this is Sam.
It's an honor to meet you, sir.
It's an honor to meet you.
Hey, this person's all right.
Okay, I'm holding a baby.
Talk to him as if he's a real person.
Prince Topher, Jean-Michel has something he'd like to say to you.
These people have had their land taken from them. And I know I've said this before, but I now know what it truly means to have someone you love lose their home. We need your help. We need to have our voices heard.
Yes. Yes, I know what it's like to be overlooked, trust me. I want to help you, but how?
Fol-de-roy and fiddle-dee-dee, fiddle-dee-faddle-dee-faddle. All the dreamers in the world go whoops and out they tumble.
Of course, it's here.
What's here?
Do you know it?
I read it at university.
Look, chapter 2.
Of course, chapter 2.
Chapter 2? I never got that far.
Chapter 2, I should have known. People, I think I have a plan.
I knew you would.
Long live Prince Topher.
Our future king.
Prince Topher, what are you doing surrounded by these ragamuffins?
Sebastian, you said nobody needed my help. What do you call these people?
Well, from their attire, I assume artists.
We demand to have our voices heard.
Yeah! A beheading wouldn't be out of place here.
Yes, yes, everyone must be heard. That's a great idea.
What is going on?
Now there's a way for all to be seen and heard. It's in this book. In 1 month, we will all vote for a new job. I shall create the post of Prime Minister, someone who will counsel me. I nominate our current Lord Protector. Sebastian.
Oh, I am unworthy, sire.
I also nominate this man, Jean-Michel.
What? Oh.
Now, let the people decide. The way things are and the way things could be. Everyone, rich and poor, will have one vote.
One person, one vote? Where's the fun in that?
People, in 1 month, I give you an election. Yes, that's a great idea. Now everyone, rich and poor, into the castle for a free banquet.
Hooray! You did it!
I did do it. I did do it. And you showed me the way.
You're smiling. I mean, I've seen you smile before, but never like that.
You showed me who I can be. A kind, just, fair king.
You seem so sure of yourself, so sure of everything.
I feel like I can answer any question that gets thrown at me.
You can!
With you, I can. There's just one question I don't know the answer for. Do I love you because you're wonderful? Or are you wonderful because I love you? Are you making believe I see in you a girl too lovely to be really true? Do I want you because you're beautiful? Or are you because I want you? Are you the sweet invention of a lover's dream? Or are you really as beautiful as you seem?
Thank you.
wonderful as you seem.
Now I feel like I can truly change the world, you and I.
To the banquet?
To the banquet.
What time is it?
Only midnight. Why?
Midnight? I have to go.
What? Again?
I don't want to go, but I have to.
How can you leave me? Why do you leave me?
If you saw me for who I truly was, you would never love me.
Don't leave me.
I must go.
Please, someone, guard, someone, please, help. Ha!
And all is well. A great day in the kingdom. In 1 month marks our first free election for Prime Minister of the land. Our candidates are our current Lord and Protector, Sebastian, and of course, Jean-Michel. But first, all women come to the palace to try on the glass slipper. Whosoever fits it shall be married to the prince. That was the biggest newscast I've ever casted. I'll be back at 11 with weather and sports. The prince intends to search until he finds the girl who fits the bill. Well, not the bill, the shoe, I mean the shoe to fit a queen. The shoe does not fit. The shoe does not fit.
We must find this girl. If the slipper's made of glass, then it can only fit one person. That's why she left it, right?
It does not look good.
How goes it?
So far, no luck.
Now, for a family, you shall try on the shoe first and make sure you make eye contact with His Highness.
No one's seen Gabrielle since you yelled at her 2 days ago. Yeah, and you kicked her out because she likes that guy who might be our new prime minister. Great job there.
I don't know what's going on in this world. Everything I felt was holy and true is now trash. Everything that meant nothing to me now means everything.
Me again. Hey.
Gabrielle, I've decided. If I become Prime Minister, I'm going to marry you.
Wow, the stakes are really piling up.
It does not fit.
Of course it doesn't fit. I'm not the girl the prince has fallen in love with. None of us are that girl.
Is she really the last eligible lady in the kingdom?
She appears to be, yes.
She can't be.
I told you she wouldn't show. Can we please end this charade?
Did everyone truly try on the slipper?
I haven't tried on the slipper.
Everything has led you to this moment. Now you have something to believe in. Yourself.
All the dreamers in the world are dizzy in the noodle.
Go on, make yourself ridiculous. Try on the slipper.
It's too rich.
You can do it.
That's my sister.
Have we met before?
Yes, and we're seeing each other for the very first time right now.
The shoe fits!
It was you! You who danced with me, you who showed me my kingdom, you who gave me water when I was thirsty. Please don't run away again. I don't think I could bear it.
I know how poorly I've treated you since your father has passed away. I'm not sure if I'm worthy of your famous kindness. I'm not worthy.
Madame, you have treated me very poorly indeed. But now I say to you the three kindest words I know. I forgive you.
Thank you.
Do you think that might include me?
For you, it includes several hours of community service.
You're amazing. Do you think I could maybe learn your name now?
Cinderella.
Cinderella, it's beautiful.
It's a name I once hated, but starting today, I'll keep. So that whenever anyone thinks something is impossible, they'll just say my name and know better.
Cinderella, I love you so much. I don't know what to do.
Well, is marriage still on the table?
Oh, yes, yes, oh my, yes, you have to marry me. Will you marry me? Sorry. Cinderella, will you marry me?
Yes, my handsome prince, I will marry you. In the arms of my love, I'm flying over mountain and meadow and glen.
And I like it so well.
And I like it so well.
Therefore,
and I like it so well.
And
I like it so well.
Therefore, all I can tell, I may never come down again. I may never come down to earth again.
Ah!